Hello everyone, Alex here from WarrenOffKeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can create an invite notification channel, and this can basically be its own welcome channel that is going to notify everyone who actually invited the new user, and also how many invites the inviter now has. Now this video is an extension off of the previous video where I show you how to make an invites command that will show the top three members and who has invited people. A link to that will be in the video description. However, this exact functionality was a request by one of the members within the Warnoff Keys Discord, so if you do have any video requests, make sure to go ahead and ask or suggest them in the suggestions channel right here, and I'll look at them and see what I can do. But to get started, we can go into our project, and I'm going to make a new file. This one is going to be called invite-notifications.js. Here we're going to export a function, so module.exports. We're going to take in a client as the only argument. Now we can go into our main file, and I'm going to import this. So constant invite notifications equals require invite notifications. Now I can actually call this, passing in our client. We can save this and close index. All of our functionality will be in here. So the concept behind this is we're going to want to first log all of the invites and how many each user has. And then whenever someone joins, we're going to want to loop through all of the previous invites and all of the new invites and see which one has increased by one. Currently, this is the only way we can do this within Discord.js. There is no way to directly or cleanly get the actual invite used or the inviter from a new member. Hopefully, this is something they'll add in the future, but for now, we have to use this implementation. So I'm going to create an object called invites, and this is going to be something that'll be set up with the guild ID being the primary key here, and then we're going to have another object as the value, and inside we're going to have the member ID being that key and then the count. And so we first want to actually fill this variable with actual information. And so we want to loop through all of the guilds or all the servers that our bot is inside of. So I'm going to make a function here. This will be called get invite counts. And this is going to be an asynchronous function that'll take in a guild. And inside of here, we're going to return await new promise with resolve being the only argument we care about. So this is why this is an asynchronous function, because we're using await right here. Now inside, we're going to fetch all the invites from the guild, so we can use guild.fetchInvites. And this returns a promise, so we can use .then, and we're going to get access to the invites. Now inside, I'm going to create a variable called inviteCounter. This is going to be an object, and it'll be set up similar to how this is set up right here. So we're going to have an object, and then the key is going to be the member ID, and the value is going to be the actual count. So now we need to loop through all the invites, so we can say invites.forEach. This is going to loop through with a callback. And now we need to destructure some information about the invites. But first, to actually get a better understanding, let's actually console log this. So now this function here isn't being ran. So below the function, we want to loop through all of the guilds that the server is in. So client.guilds.cache.forEach. And this is going to be a function that'll have a guild object here. We could then say invites index of guild.id. We're now actually filling information into this variable right here. And we see that the main key is going to be the guild ID. And then we're going to get this object here, which just happens to be what this function returns. And so we're going to call that. So we're going to say equals await get invite counts. We're going to pass in the guild. Now, because we're using await here, this function has to be asynchronous. Now we can save this and I can restart the bot. We see a bunch of information about the different invites. So scrolling up, we see uses and inviter. And if you watched the previous video, this looks familiar because this is very similar code. We actually need to gain access to this. So we're going to destructure them. So we're going to destructure the uses and then the inviter from invite. And then inside of the inviter, we want access to the username and the discriminator. So we're going to destructure those from the inviter variable that we now have. So const username and discriminator equals inviter. So we're destructuring those into their own variable. Now we need to actually concatenate these two together using a template literal. So constant name. We're going to pass in the username, a hash symbol, and then the discriminator. And then we're going to say invite counter index of name equals. Now here we want to see if we have a previous counter to see if this person has any invites that we've already taken note of. And so we could say invite counter index of name or zero. So this is essentially saying, do we have any previous invites that we know about already stored? If so, use those. However, if this is undefined, which it would be during like the first invite we find, for example, then we're just going to use zero. Now this is within parentheses because after this, we're going to say plus uses, which is what we destructure right here. Now, if we go outside of this for each loop, we can resolve, returning the invite counter, and this function should be done. So now what I can do is I can actually console log saying invites, and I'm going to then say invites index of guild.id, which is the result right here. So if I save this and we restart the bot, we then see that I have invited 57 people and these two users have invited 0 at the moment. Now we have access to all the information we need. I can get rid of this console log. And now we're going to listen for whenever users actually join the Discord. So we can say client.on guild member add. And this is going to give us a member object inside of a callback here. So the first thing we want is we want to destructure the guild object or guild property from the member object. And then we're going to create two variables. The first one is going to be called invites before, and this is just going to be invites index of guild.id. Now this is referencing the variable we have at the top of our file way up here, and we haven't actually changed anything or fetched the new invites. And so this is essentially what we already have cached. Now we go here, we can say const invites after, and we can say await get invite counts and pass in the guild. Now, because we're using await, this has to be an asynchronous function. And we can console log these. So we can say before, we can pass in invites before, and then I'm going to copy and paste this, and I'm going to console log invites after, and we'll say after. Now I'm going to save this and restart the bot. I'm then going to import a test account to the server. And we see this in the console right here. So before I had 57 uses, and then after I have 58. And so now we can actually loop through this and see if I actually have increased or whoever has increased by one, and then credit them for the invite. With that said, I can say for const inviter in invites after. And so this is going to give me the key. So for example, the first iteration will be my user, and then the second user, and then this third user. And so now we can actually gain access to the counts that they have. So we can say if invites before index of inviter is exactly equal to invites after index of inviter. And we can use the same exact key here, even though these are two separate objects, because the keys are always the same and we know that. But we wanted to say invites after minus one. So invites after is when it's actually increased by one. And so this entire statement is saying if what we had before is exactly equal to the new value minus one. And so this essentially is saying that this person's invites have actually increased, which means that we know that they invited this person. Inside, we want to make sure that we return before we do anything else. But before the actual return, we're then going to get the channel ID, and we're going to send a message to a test channel. However, you might want to make this a configurable thing, and I go over how to do that within my per server settings video, which will be linked in the video description. In there, I show you how to create a welcome channel that the server owners can configure through their own welcome message. And so this is going to be a very similar system to what you'd want to actually use for the invite notifications. However, for simplicity, I'm just going to add in my channel ID here. I'm going to paste this in, and I got this by going to Discord, and then I can right click on the channel here and click on copy ID. And if you don't have access to this, you have to enable developer mode on your Discord account. So if I paste this in here, it's the same thing. I could then say const channel equals guild, which we have access to from destructuring it here on line 28, guild.channels.cache.get channel ID. And this is the syntax to retrieve a channel from a specific guild. And then I'm going to create a count variable. This will equal invites after index of inviter. And then I could say channel.send with a template literal. We'll say please welcome, and we're going to tag the new member. The syntax for this is less than, at symbol, greater than. But then before the end of it, right after the at symbol, we're going to actually mention ID. And so this is something we can destructure from the member. And this is just the syntax to actually tag the member. So please welcome this person to the Discord. Invited by, let me scroll up a little bit. So invited by, and then we want to actually add in the inviter. And then we can add in parentheses, we can add in count invites. So this is going to welcome the new member, and then directly afterwards it's going to mention who invited them and how many invites they have. So if I save this and we restart the bot, I'm now going to invite my test account. And inside the channel here, we see please welcome testing account to the Discord invited by my username. And then it says I have 59 invites. Now the last step is we see that we actually update our invites variable once the server actually starts. However, we're never updating that again. And so we actually have access to the most updated information with invites after. So after we send the information, we can say invites index of guild.id equals invites after. And this is going to make sure that our invites variable, which is at the top up here, has the most up-to-date information. So whenever someone new joins after this has already ran once, it's going to have the correct information to be able to correctly identify who actually invited someone. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.